Hey guys, this is the cargo container light fighter by Microsoft Word. So I saw this on the workshop. I think I saw some images of the container opening, but you know, I haven't really checked what's really in the container. I'm guessing there's like a fighter in the container. We're not gonna peek inside just yet. There is almost nothing on the exterior of the container other than some, you know, conveyors. So this container costs 10,745 PCO with 2,713 blocks. Yeah, there are definitely something or a lot of things in there. Alright, let's find the button here. I don't see any button. Maybe the button is up here. Wait, what? You guys can see the seam on the armor, right? So this is meant to be open somehow. Maybe there's like no exterior button. Really? Should we just peek inside then? That's not a fighter. So I'm guessing this is the right orientation. Wait, what? I don't really get this thing. So I'm guessing the button is somewhere. There we go. I think that's the button. Wait. That's not gonna be enough for the things in here to get out, right? What's going on? Maybe there's another button. No, that's the same button. Well, what? I'm pretty sure these are custom missiles. And I'm guessing this is the main cockpit of the whole thing. What? Camera control? Railgun? Turn on the gyroscope of the thingy. Hold on, maybe it will make more sense once we roll the thing. There's a merch block there. Wait. I turned off the merch block and something exploded. Hold on, let me spawn a new one here. So, we get inside from this hole. Then we open the container. Then we turn on the gyroscopes of the thingy. Then, well, we roll to the right orientation. Is this the right orientation? Alright, and now we detach the thingy. We didn't explode there. So now, how do we get this thing out of the container? Landing gear? No. Can you get me out of here? Hold on, this must be some really smart engineering that I just don't understand. These are ion engines, so this only work in space. Hold on. I'm getting inside. Turn on the gyroscope and detach the thingy. And now, oh, there we go. I think I understand now. Hold on. Wait, how do I see now. So, the upper section of the cargo container is part of the fighter's armor. What the hell? This is such a unique way to design a fighter. I mean, it's very impractical, but you know, let's see how the thing itself performed though. Oh, this is a very maneuverable fighter. I think this is actually more maneuverable than it needs to be. We do have railguns though, and you know, Gatling guns as well. So the building technique of integrating the upper section of the container as the armor of the fighter itself is pretty cool, but practically speaking, because you know, you're most likely gonna be shot by enemies from the front of the fighter, the upper armor doesn't really do that much in terms of protecting the actual fighter. So still pretty cool though. Look at all those custom missiles, by the way. So I guess the idea is that you'll be able to, you know, carry your fighter in this protective shell so that it doesn't get damaged when you transport the fighter in heavy combat environment until you actually need to deploy the fighter. Realistically speaking, on space engineers though, that's not gonna be a really practical, you know, like strategy. But, you know, this is one of those builds that are meant to be cool and stuff. Let's check the actual container itself. What the hell? Why is there so many batteries in the container? I guess you can actually reuse the container. Hold on, I'm gonna try to land back inside the container. Come on. Turn on the merge block. Hey, there we go. We're back inside the container. I mean, that's actually pretty cool. Alright, so the ion engines can actually work in atmosphere. I mean the thrusters. So we're gonna drop this on the planet and we're gonna see whether or not we can, you know, deploy ourselves. I need to turn off the thrusters again. Alright, so the container is dropping to the planet and, well, let's say that we're inside the fighter. Make sure we're on the right orientation. Oh, that's the wrong button. Hold on. Whoops. Alright, here we go again. Opening the container. Turning on the gyroscope and the thruster. Make sure we're on the right orientation. Alright. Turning on my dampeners. And now we're gonna detach the container. Oh, there we go. That's pretty cool. I mean, the, you know, performance in gravity is not really that amazing, but you know, this is meant to be a space fighter, I guess. Let's say that you got dropped at a bad location and, well, let's say that you cannot open the container to get out in time. Let's see how much the container will actually protect the thing from, you know, collision damage. All right. Here goes. Alright. Seems to be protecting us rather well actually. Like the outer layer of the armor is acting like an impact buffer so that the container is the thing that gets damaged rather than the actual fighter inside the container. Almost there. Almost there. Alright. Oh wow. Let's see if the container is still working or not. I can still open the container. I'm gonna separate the fighter from the container. Separation. Then we're gonna delete the container. So we can see how much damage the actual fighter, you know, got on it. Well, I mean, I guess a lot of the damage kind of went through the armor because a lot of the outer layer of the armor is still pretty close to the fighter itself. But, you know, all things considered, considering the height that we were falling from, I would say that's a decent amount of protection. Let's see if this actually still works in space. Yeah, I mean, this still rather functional. Alright, let's see how well this will do in combat situation. I'm just gonna add more weapons to this station here. So, let's say that we found an enemy space station. Since, you know, the fighter itself got like its own propulsion, we are gonna use the container itself as armor. Then we're gonna detach the container once we're closer to the station. Alright, I get ready. Here it goes. Oh, bit of the armor broke off there. Almost there. Alright, I'm gonna detach the container now. Waiting for initial enemy fire. Alright, now we're getting out of the thing. Come on, shoot. Shoot it. What the hell? Oh. Are we still... I mean... Hold on, let me try to disable the enemy. starts here. Come on. No, no, no. Ah. Alright, that was my fault. But, well, obviously, you can do like a similar tactic just using like, you know, an armor plate that you carry on your landing gear or whatever. And it's probably gonna be a lot cheaper. Still though, that was pretty cool. Oh, look at the thing still rolling there. What the hell? But yeah, well, obviously, this is not like a practical survival design. But still, it's always cool to see this kind of unique builds on space engineers. Hold on, let me try one more thing here. What if I, like, you know, stay in the thingy without detaching the container? I'm just gonna shoot from inside the container itself. Getting closer. Fire, oops. Ah, come on, fire. Aha, you weren't expecting the container to fight. Oh, it's so slow. Alright, I'm gonna detach the container and we're gonna fly outside. Yeah, this fighter definitely needs more acceleration. Come on, we're still alive. I'm dodging the enemy. Yeah, I can barely dodge using this fighter. There's not enough acceleration. There goes the fighter. So yeah, that's the cargo container light fighter by Microsoft Word. You guys can find the link in the description below. Oh, never mind. I thought there was gonna be like more damage to the thing. This is quite the nice station actually. I should probably preview this station.